shooting your shit, drinking some beer, catch a fish, drinking beer by the barrel. It's Country Livin with Matt Wessel and Friends. All right. So are you ready?
Off camera real quick. You should be good if you go. Okay, just go around the back of the car and run inside.
Welcome, Dr. Reverend.
Welcome, Matt.
Come on in.
Okay.
Hey, everybody. My name is Matt Wessel, and we're at the cabin. Country Livin' Matt Wessel and Friends series premiere. So, it's definitely a relatively lovely February, but it's still kind of nippy, and we're going to try to heat up the cabin. We're going to use the performer. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fill this pot with water. It's to keep the place from drying up. If you don't have any water evaporating while you have your fire going, then you're just going to get a lot of static electricity. Oh, hey, we have to turn on the water first.
All right. What's that do?
That's the dampener. I can't remember which way opens it, which way closes it. I'm going to say to the right is open. We'll kind of keep the door open for a while anyhow. I think we're probably ready to rock and roll.
All right.
Or at least try her. You know, and just light it up in a number of places. Try to ensure the success and distribution of the fire. Kind of just let it do its thing for a little bit. One thing you need to be aware of, if you have a wood stove and you're splitting wood to accommodate the fuel for the wood stove, you might want to split them into very tiny pieces so they'll fit in it. Yeah, it may or may not pick up all the way, but at least Well, I'll just kind of let it percolate for a while and let the kindling kind of do something. And we'll just leave it for a couple minutes and then check up on it again.
Where are your other things at?
Girl, I'm going to name you Clarence. Come here, Clarence. Come here, Clarence.
She responds to that. You can tell.
Clarence! Throw a water balloon at it. At her.
I didn't bring any this time.
Son of a bitch.
We unpacked everything else that was in our car and let it some time pass. And the fire is doing pretty well. I don't think I really need to do anything to it. I'm going to demonstrate a proper method of rope climbing. So we may have to bring the camera up closer just whenever I get up higher.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Just think about that. All right.
Okay, so I'll just do my thing.
Yep, I'll bring the camera up.
Okay, really the only thing I can tell you as a particular technique is the way your feet should be positioned to make yourself comfortable. So that kind of feels like you're just standing on something rather than having to grab it. You can see it's just kind of, my foot is standing, and then this is the friction to on my other foot to ensure that it just doesn't slip away. But yeah, you can just kind of maintain that. And you have an anchor to stand on to. That's a technique that my uncle taught me, and he learned that when he was in the army, just basic training stuff. Whew. All right, I guess I'll swing on it now.
Yeah. Get your swing on.
Get the swinging.
Get your swing on. Come on.
Okay. Now my brother taught me how to swing on this really good. All right. Just kind of relax. Let your feet do some work for a bit. There's only so much distance you can do with this method. And you gotta stand up. Anytime you're down the ground, your body is down, and then your body goes up when you're on the sides. And you lean back and push forward, and kick your feet forward. You keep doing this, and you will gain a surprising amount of momentum. I'm unraveling.
I'm having a lot of trouble following you.
I bet.
Here, I know what I'm gonna do. Oh, very nice.
Down and then up. And then down and then up.
I'm getting some great upskirt shots of you over here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Me gusta.
And then eventually, you may cease to go in a straight line and almost hit the roof. And that's where I'm going to stop. And you'll get tired pretty quick doing this too.
Time for beer. You've earned a beer, I'd say.
I think we're ready to drink some beer.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm sorry, I didn't see you over there. I'm the Reverend Doctor, and this is today's sermon. I've got beer in my nose. I'm gonna show you today how to shotgun beer. You're gonna need a beer. And
a shotgun,
a knife, and a shotgun. got beer in my nose. All right, so get your knife. What I like to do is crack the beer first. This relieves air pressure so that when you eventually puncture the beer down here, it won't like go all over the fucking place. So, got it cracked open a little bit just to relieve some pressure. Now, this is important, kids. Look at you. Make sure you hold the knife with the sharp edge away from yourself. Trust me, it can hurt.
This man has worked in kitchens for years. He knows about knives.
I've also been drinking for years. So I know about knives. So you just puncture it. I'm gonna zoom in on that. Kind of like about right around the ass crack. Right, yeah. Right around just like it's anywhere kind of down nuts here. On me. And you wanna make sure also that you're lining it up so that, see, here's the top, here's the mouth fuck hole thing. And you want to line it up so that mouth hole thing and then your hole's going to be down here. It just makes it a lot easier. Trust me. Just give it a little, there you go. See? Just a little bit. And then.
Go, 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 go.
Well, that was 12 ounces of beer consumed in 5 or 6 all seconds, right. Maybe a little longer than that.
That was today's sermon with the good reverend. Now go to bed!
What's up, Matt? Burn pizza. So, Matt, tell us about your dick.
Everybody, my name is Justin King, and I'm here with the world famous
Matt's dick.
Cork. Woo! Now, Matthew Wessel's cork, I have a question. Woo! Is it true or not that you have fucked Lindsay Lohan?
Matt's ornamental dick!
Your personal accessory to Miss January, is there any truth to this rumor?
Yes, and January Jones as well! She titty fucked me!
That's quality TV right there!
Daddy's little guy's all grown up.
It is. This week, outdoor life.
Uh-oh, here it goes. He's going for it.
Oh. No means no, Mr. Gigantic.
Yeah.
Slip?
Oh, yeah, I heard that. I want to hear that out of the Girl with the Dragon Tattoo soundtrack. It's 3 hours long. You produce that. It's 3 days.
I got it.
It was just his grin the entire time. Dude, Mr. Gigantic's a pervert.
Clearly they like each other, okay?
Dude, just Rex just brings us out in every dog.
Rex is a slut.
Now they're best friends.
Matt Well.
Yeah.
He was just in slacks and she just had her ass wrapped around
his
head.
He's on his lunch break.
Dude, do we need to have the hot water on right now?
He's thawing the dogs. Hey, has anybody seen a really funny porno lately? John Mattingly, have you seen any funny pornos lately?
No, no, there's no such thing. Probably.
All pornos.
I tried to set him up. God damn it.
Thanks for the effort.
No, it's not. It was a perfect setup.
Not at all.
Trying to help this man out.
That's not up.
It was exactly. It was the only setup that could be done.
Yeah, but for real, it was fucking hilarious. It was like, and I kept fast forwarding to think like, we're gonna have to start fucking here sooner or later.
Yeah, yeah.
This whole, no, all it was like 10 minutes of just this lady's ass like, wrapped around this dude's head. And just going.
At least he didn't insert his entire head into her.
Oh God, I'm trying to forget that.
The shaving is key. It's absolutely key for that maneuver. Trust me.
Trice has learned the hard way.
I know, right?
Have
you ever heard of
that? That's the reason for the shaved head, Lord. Just like, just get a hose and some Lysol afterwards. It's all done. Never like to start with
that. Way too late.
Watch me just stop.
Right in the middle. Right in the middle.
Oh!
They're right.
Ooh!
Oh!
In the cup.
Oh!
Oh!
He can't.
Elliot made it in the cup.
Okay. Boom!
Matt's dick.
That's right.
How much fun are you having tonight? Are you having a wonderful evening?
This is really embarrassing.
Tell the world, Elliot.
This is really embarrassing.
Well, tell the world, good God.
I really have to piss.
Motherfucker. You little piece of shit. Alright. Nope, I didn't drive.
Alright.
And I don't drive stick. That's what she said.
I wasn't gonna say anything.
Well, you can look at me and probably tell that I'm pretty hungover right now. So we've everybody's left. It's just Dr. Reverend and I. And Mr. Gigantic.
That dog done got humped.
He humped the dog. The dog humped him. Also in his past, he's pissed on our snowman that we made a couple winters ago. And he also ran off with a dead mouse with the mouse trap still attached to the mouse.
We were going to give that motherfucker a Viking funeral, proper like.
The performer did well tonight. It got really toasty here. I guess it's about all we got. So, what did we learn? Well, you learned how to climb a rope properly with exerting the least amount of energy as possible. My foot is standing, and then this is the friction to on my other foot to ensure that it just doesn't slip away. But yeah, you can just kind of maintain that. And you have an anchor to stand onto. Like, you learn how to swing on a rope really high. Just kind of relax. Let your feet do some work for a bit. Anytime you're down the ground, your body is down. And then your body goes up when you're on the sides. And you lean back and push forward. You kick your feet forward. You keep doing this, and you will gain a surprising amount of momentum. What else did we teach? You learned how to shotgun a beer.
Got it cracked open a little bit just to relieve some pressure. See, here's the top, here's the mouth fuck hole thing. And you want to line it up so that mouth hole thing and then your hole's going to be down here. It just makes it a lot easier, trust me. Give it a little, there you go, see? Just a little bit. And then...
Go, let's go. You learned how... come on, help me out, what else happened?
Got the wood stove working. Got a tour of the cabin.
Yeah, learn how to work the wood stove. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fill this pot with water. It's to keep the place from drying up. Light it up in a number of places. We unpacked everything else that was in our car and let it some time pass. And the fire is doing pretty well. I don't think I really need to do anything to it.
Looked at us really drunk.
Looked at us being really drunk.
Matt's dick!
Cock!
Matt's ornamental dick!
Yeah, just like Daddy taught him. There you go.
I got it. I got it.
Yeah, but for real, it was fucking hilarious. It was like, he's going.
It's the sound of science. It's the sound of Matt's dick.
Matt's dick. Matt's dick.
So I think that about sums it up. So until next time, this is Matt Wessel reminding you to be a good parent, live off the land, go to your local library, feed your brain, and stay active. And get the fucking!
And we're recording. We're hot.
All right.
That overlooks the avenue. With someone sharing a delight. Listen back, cocktails for two. As we enjoy a cigarette, to some exquisite chansonette, two hands are sure to slyly meet beneath a serviette.
We should label all the tapes too.
Yeah, just like episode 1, part 1.
Or that one's just specifically. I don't know, it could be a specific or whatever label.
Most any afternoon to time. We'll be so glad we're both alive. Then maybe fortune will come.
Doesn't that look good? Tape 1, episode 1. Wait. I haven't heard this song in so long.